On today's show, we talked to SLCC film student Tyler Harrah about his new film, The Cyclical Crucible. That's what's coming up on Bruin Lens. So today, I'm here with Tyler Harrah. Tyler, welcome. Good to see you.
Pleasure
now,
to be here.
Now, you're an SLCC film student. So, how long have you been making films?
So I've been acting and writing for as long as I can remember, but specifically like making my own independent shorts since middle school. So if it was 2010, I'd have been like 13.
Gotcha.
That's when I got into that.
And, you know, what brought you to Slick? Of all the places in Utah to come to film,
yeah.
Why come to Slick?
Well, I love their emphasis on the technical side of film. I mean, theory is obviously important, but I mean, the thing with film school doesn't guarantee you a job
right.
in this industry,
right.
not at all. So it's not for everybody. And what's more, not every film school is for everybody.
Right.
So you gotta find the one for you. And I'm very like well-versed in theory. I've been, you know, analyzing film for years and years, and I love, I don't know, I'm a big fan of just surrealism in film and like weird art films that people don't usually like. So it's like I've kind of got that down pat. It was like I want to get my hands on some great gear
right.
and have a lot of hands-on experience, and that's what Slick offers, and
good,
that's
good.
What I love.
So let's talk about the film The Cyclical Crucible. First of all, you got to tell me a little bit about where you came up with the title.
It was really informed by the content. I don't know, I hesitate. Because I'm like, if I say I'm great at coming up with titles, people are going to look at all my titles and be like, oh, that one's not that good. But truly, I was like, well, what's a like, I don't know. My big thing was, because this is a film about a young man who wakes up one morning and he gets into an argument with his wife. She stabs him. And from then on, like he keeps dying and coming back to life over and over again in all these different lives. So we see things, you know, that are currently things that were in his life, things that could have been or could be, we don't know for sure, and we see some peeks into the future, and it's kind of up to the audience to decide which is which. But this idea of like through great trial and like life itself being such a I don't know, almost like a vicious cycle of abuse, right? We
yeah.
just we try our hardest, then we get
right,
beat down over
right,
and over
right.
again. It's that and like drawing from Arthur Miller's The Crucible, right, in terms
nice.
Of like we're put
sure.
through this sort of refining process
right.
to then become something better, but we go
right.
through it over and over again, and that's life.
Good.
So that's where that came
so
from.
So we've got a little clip here to show everybody. So set up the clip for us a little bit. What's going on in this clip we're going to see?
So it's that first scene that I described there. This is Jamie, played by Kendall Whitesides, and he's currently arguing with his wife Maud, played by Savannah Malloy, and we just see it escalate and get into some very surreal elements from there. So.
All right, good. Let's roll the clip.
If you've been worrying about it, why haven't we talked about it? Why haven't you brought it up?
Can we talk about it, though? I feel like every time we've talked about it.
Okay. I'm ready to see it.
Thank you. That's the goal.
Now, we only get a little, right? The clip there gives us a little taste.
Right.
What do you want the audience to come away from it after they see this? That's a hard question, right?
Truly. Because, I mean, and maybe this is, maybe this was bad, but, like, a lot of this film, film for me, like, you've heard that expression, oh, art, it's a way of survival, if you will. But, like, truly, film, for me, it's like when I'm stressed, when I have problems in my life, like, I make a film to kind of help myself sort of, sort through it, compartmentalize it, and then I can almost put it on a shelf
no,
in
right.
a way. And so with this film, the idea was pitched to me just like, oh, guy keeps, you know, waking up in these different lives. Maybe each one says something a little bit about him. But I was able to really take that idea and go deeper. And so I won't say how much, but I will say there are lots of elements here and specific directions I gave the actors that may or may not even come through in the film that that are very much like me and like ways I feel about certain things or, I don't know, sort of a commentary on those. But I guess what I want everyone to come out of it with is well, that is a difficult question. I'm not sure. I guess I want everyone to just come here. I won't say anything. I'll just say I want everyone to come out of it with their own genuine interpretation of it, it how they need to change themselves in their life, or whether they think the film was, you know, complete rubbish. So
now that you've poured your blood, sweat, and tears for an entire semester into this project, what's next?
Well, so I'm gonna shoot a documentary in Tahiti for like a study abroad. Nice. Get some school credit while I'm at it. So that'll be lovely. And that's this Monday. So I'll do that, and take care of it. And then I've got two films from 2018 that we'd almost shot in their entirety, but we were finally able to finish those up. And now it's just a matter of editing them and releasing them this summer, actually.
Yeah. And I hear you've got your own YouTube channel where you're putting regular content up. Give us the name. Tell us a little bit about that real quick.
Yeah, for sure. So it's called A Tyler Harrah Film. Before, I just sort of like whenever I could, I'd post, if you will. Like it's like whenever I made a film, just whenever I got to the next one, I would post. But I was like, I need to make things more consistently. And what's more, in with school, now that film's homework, I still need film that's just for me. So I've started a series called Cinetographique. It's a word I made up. Not even a real word.
There you go.
It's the name of my series.
All words are made up, right?
Well, truly. And it's an experimental film series. I post every Saturday. At least I try to, right here at the end of the semester. It's gotten a little iffy. But I mean, with the summer too, like I'm going to be more consistent with releasing every Saturday. And I hope to like ramp up my show a little bit too. But each one's like just an experiment. It's trying something new with film that I haven't done before.
Good.
And it's trying to get people talking about important social issues as well as just the technique of film.
Excellent. One final thing. Advice for a new student coming into the film program. You know, you're now, you got your own film.
Mm-hmm.
What's your advice to a new student coming in?
Take advantage of as many of the extracurricular stuff that's offered to you as possible. The film professors here are very good about posting, you know, job offers for just local gigs. And, you know, we've got great workshops that come through here. I had the chance to help do press coverage at Sundance thanks to a listing that was here. And I met so many crazy celebrities that way,
nice.
Conducted all these great interviews, and even got an episode of my show out of it. So
excellent.
Just go for the extracurricular
Tyler,
stuff.
Tyler, thank you so much for coming and seeing us. And check out his website, A Tyler Harrah Film on YouTube. For most shows like these, go to our Facebook page at Student Media Center, SMC, or visit it on YouTube, Instagram, or Twitter at SLCC SMC. I'm your host, Matt Merkel. This has been Bruin Lens.